Right angle. Today we will learn how we can make a right angle by paper folding. I have taken an irregular piece of paper. It's an ordinary newspaper. So what we do is we fold the newspaper once. The first fold we can do it in any way, but the second fold is special. Now what we do is we fold it in such a way that, can you see these two folds? Now this should be such that one crease exactly overlaps the other. These two creases overlap. Now when I do this, I cannot see the back portion of the paper. So now when I'll open this page, now can you see four lines, or you can see two lines crossing each other? There are four right angles formed. So if I can measure the right angles, here I have an instrument which is called a protractor, and I can measure the right angle with the help of a protractor. I place one arm of the angle horizontally, and when I read the other arm here, I can see that the angle is 90 degrees, right? Now let us again fold this so that the folds again exactly overlap each other. Now what have we done here? What we get? We get a smaller angle. And what is the speciality of the smaller angle? That is that it is half of a right angle. It is half of 90 degrees. What is half of 90 degrees? Half of 90 degrees is 45 degrees. Right, so we've divided the 90 degrees angle into two equal parts, that is 45 degrees each. So if I measure this again, can you see? It is exactly equal to 45 degrees. Now let's see how I can fold. Now I'll show it on a piece of plain paper. Right, now here I've taken plain paper and I just make a fold, right? Achha. Now that I've made one fold, I haven't specially made it in any direction, it's my wish. But the second fold has to be special. I make it in such a way that this part and this part of the paper exactly overlap each other. Can you see they are overlapping? And we will not be able to see the other side. Now, if I open this paper, can you see the creases? Four creases. Now, I have done what is here. I have marked the creases in green. And how many angles are formed? Four angles are formed. And each one is equal to a right angle. I have also cut this. Can you see? I have cut this one part of the right angle. So this is one right angle, and this blank portion is also a right angle, and these are three right angles. So let's say, where do we find right angles in our daily life? Can you see? This is a remote. If I put it here, are the two sides of the remote at right angles? Yes. Here also the two sides of the remote are at right angles. Right? Okay. I can also measure the corner of this remote. It is a right angle. Now in the same way, I can show you that here I have a bottle, and if I place this here, now the lid of the bottle is at right angles to the this part of the bottle, right? So we can show it here. I will show you another bottle now, and that is this one. Now all the sides are at right angles to each other. So if I place it here, it is at right angles. I can place it here, it's at right angles. Place it here, it's at right angles. And this also is at right angles, right? Okay. I can also show you To measure this corner, it is a right angle. I can measure this corner of the bottle, it is a right angle. Now let me show you a box. Now here I have a box. Now, is it a right angle? This corner? Yes, it is a right angle. Now I can measure it with this and I can also measure it with this. Right? So I have measured this corner of the box as a right angle in two ways. Now mostly the carpenters use this type of a scale. One part is going down and one part is here. So they use these scales to make their corners. If you like this video, then please like it, share it, and subscribe to the channel.